Welcome to Make the Grade with the Success Doctor, Stephen Green, where you'll discover actionable strategies to help your student to reach their academic goals, to excel at standardized testing, and to plan for the college admissions process painlessly. And now, here's your host, Dr. Stephen Green.
Hey, welcome back. Dr. Stephen Green, the Success Doctor. Big going ons here. You know what today is? Well, it's going to be different wherever you are in listening, but at this exact moment, this is the big reveal day. You know what that means? So for somebody who does a lot of test prep, I help students with SATs. I help students with ACTs, you know, the big exams to help them get into college. This is a huge day because the scores for the most recent SAT exam are posting. So I woke up and I'm getting texts and emails and phone messages from the many, many students I helped to prep for the test reporting their scores. So that's what we're going to talk about today. What do you do? And this is a big range of emotions here. Some people super happy, some, I'm going to be honest, still disappointed. Not necessarily because they got bad scores. Maybe they just didn't hit goals. So let's talk about it. Parents, this is really for you. Students, this is really for you. This is important information, especially if you're early in the test cycle. The test process, the test prep process tends to be a very protracted thing. It can be months. You prep, you take a test, you analyze, you prep again, you take another test. You analyze. So let me start off with one of my sayings. One of the Make the Grade Dr. Stephen Green Success Doctor's isms. Your target school should determine your target score. So I'm going to say it again for emphasis. Your target school should determine your target score. Now, why am I going to lead with that? Here's why. Because people are chasing scores sometimes. What you shouldn't do is should do is think about this. Why are you even bothering with an SAT or an ACT to begin with? Answer, you want to get into the college or university that you want to go to. That's it. That is how you, quote unquote, doing that with my fingers here, win. So you can actually overscore. If you want to go to a school that needs an 1100 SAT, what do you need a 1410 for? It's a great score, fabulous score. But we base our goals, when we set goals, and we set goals constantly working with students, and we refine them constantly. But when you set a target score, it should be based on your end goal, which is the school, the college, the university that you would like to go to. So a couple quick things. I'm going to break this down. Number one, right now it is December. So people may be listening to this in the summer, but so in December, and I have a whole nother podcast that addressed this and will again, it's early in the process. If you're a junior in high school or you are a parent with a junior in high school, it's early. You got multiple, 5, 6, maybe 8 more times chances you could take an exam. So nobody, regardless of what your score was, should be in any sort of panic mode. This is refinement. This is a mode of analysis. So let's talk about a couple of circumstances. Let's say, and this happened, somebody comes in, they exceeded their expectations. They get a score that's 50 points higher than they ever thought they could get. And you know what it is? You walk away. If you have a number that you know, or you're very, very confident, will get you into the school you want to get into, you're done. Congratulations. Well done. Great job. You took advantage of the system. You were consistent in your prep. And you got the job done. That is always the goal. Whether it takes 1 sitting, 2, 5, however many times you got to take these tests, that is the goal. Let's go other way around. Let's say you got a disappointing score. And again, I'm not talking empirical numbers here at all. Disappointing score for somebody might be a 1400 if their goal is a 15. Or in the ACT, it might be a 30 if their goal is a 33. But a disappointing score is a score below your goal. Okay. And again, I think I've been clear on the goal. Your target school determines your target score. Well, that's not necessarily a horrible thing because this is a process and it can be a long process. So what we do is we analyze on a lot of levels. Okay. So what's going on is we need, we meaning myself as the instructor and you as the student, we need to refine the situation. Anytime there's a prep situation, this is what gets covered. There are strategies, test-taking strategies for everything. Math, English, writing, science, reading, essays, strategy for everything. We got to deal with pacing. Maybe your score was lower than you'd hope because your pacing was off. Maybe you had a great handle on the test itself and you're rolling through the strategies, but you couldn't get it done quickly enough. Very, very common, something that needs to be addressed. So maybe your strategies weren't strong, but your pacing was good. There's every sort of permutation of this. Another thing, maybe there was just some basic skills that you weren't up to yet. Maybe there were math questions on things you haven't had in school. You know, maybe there was areas of algebra or more advanced algebra or geometry that you just have not covered academically, so you were not able to answer them well on the test. Or maybe the reading passage was particularly boring or arduous or what. But the experience of taking the test enables much more focused, functional practice leading up to the next experience. And this is what, from the prep mode, we want to take advantage of. So what we do is we look at the score, we break it down, we analyze it. How many did you get right? How many did you get wrong? There's a very analytical, empirical piece to this, but there's also a more subjective piece to it. And we look at, let's look at the positives. What did go well? What can we enhance and capitalize and create an even stronger circumstance there? Other side of it, what needs to improve? Where were the deficiencies? Were the strategies not in place? Or maybe they were, but you didn't feel like you used them as effectively as you could. Was the pacing off? Did you run out of time or did you struggle to finish in time so there was an urgency towards the end of the test? This happens. So we need to analyze this. How about the basic skills, like I mentioned before? Because this is all about repetitive, consistent practice. So that when you get into the test, you have a plan, you have confidence to execute that plan, and you can do it without getting thrown off when you do have questions that are difficult. Because it's going to happen. Very, very, very few people get perfect scores. And hats off to them. But the people who don't get perfect scores, it isn't because you're not a great student or you're not smart. It's just because some of the questions are really, really difficult. And that's how these tests are designed. So we've come to this reckoning day where the scores come in. another big question I get, and I'm going to kind of answer it assuming people are thinking of it, is how do I know if maybe I got a score I'm very happy with? Let's say my target was 1250. I got a 1240. Do I take the test again? Well, I always go back to the same thing about the target school determining your target score. If your target school changes, maybe presently your school, a 1240 would have been great. But now you say, you know what? If I got a 1240, maybe I got a shot at that next level. Maybe I got a shot at what used to be a so-called reach school that I can now capitalize on. Sometimes people surprise themselves. Oh, I'm not a good test taker. I never do well in these kind of tests. Oh, but wait, I got a great score. Yeah, and maybe you can do even better. And that's what we look for. So here's the skinny. The first test result may be great. It may be mid-range. It may be disappointing. But it's where you move from there. That's what's important. So if it's on the disappointing end of this continuum, we use all the things that happen to refine what you're doing, to strengthen and ameliorate what's already good, and we go and we bolster and fortify where some of the deficiencies might have been. If you're in the middle, that's sometimes a little bit more of a discussion. Sometimes it's a little bit harder even, because if your score is low, you know you got to do it again. If your score is in the middle, you're like, well, should I, shouldn't I? And these are all discussions that can come in. If you have any questions, you know I love feedback. This podcast is 100% about giving people actions, students, parents, people in my community, the Make the Grade online community. It's giving you actions and things you can do right now. Literally, right now, to maximize your education. I would encourage people, let's hear feedback. do have questions, anything that didn't get covered here enough, you'd like to know more about, you can email me, Dr. Stephen Green, the success doctor at S-G-R-E-E-N-E at make the grade, MAKETHEGRADE.net. Yeah. You can come and join the Facebook community. Search for the Make the Grade Maximum Education Success Community and participate. I'm going to be doing some more live streams starting in next month. Hopefully you will jump in on them as well. But this is about feedback. This is about taking action. And we go from there. So that's it for today. If you are one of the students out there that hit your numbers, reached your goal, hit your target score, congratulations to you. If you came up a little short, no big deal. Don't get down. It's a learning opportunity. That's what we are going to take advantage of, and we're going to move forward from there. So well done, everyone. Thank you. Hope you found this helpful, and catch you next time. Dr. Stephen Green, the Success Doctor, signing off.
You've been listening to Make the Grade with the Success Doctor, Stephen Green. If you enjoyed this episode, be sure to subscribe. For more resources and support, please visit makethegrade.net.